Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 1, Take 1.
The computer. It can pinpoint a landing on the moon, tell us when to leave, how to get there. In business, the computer can run a production line, keep an inventory of raw materials and finished products. It can tell you where to sell for greatest profit, keep your books, and pay your people. It can show you how to save money, how to make money, whether you're a giant corporation or a small, closely held corporation. Today, any businessman can use the computer to help him make the right decision. And that's what I'm going to be talking about. Making the right decision. Getting the right information, the comparisons, the study you need to make a money-saving, a money-making decision. You can, you know. And so can this corporate businessman. He's the owner of a corporation. He's 35 years old. And his business generates...
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 2, Take 1.
And so can this corporate businessman. He's the owner of a corporation. He's 35 years old. And his business generates enough money to take care of his needs. Food, clothing, shelter, the education of his children, and a host of et ceteras. At the end of the year, he even manages to have money left over. Profit. $3,000 of profit. And it's all his to invest in his own future and the future of his family. Well, maybe not quite all his. You see, before he can invest one penny, out come taxes. How much? Well, if he's in the 36% tax bracket, the amount is $1,080. Only $1,920 is left for Mr. Businessman. All his to invest. Now, it isn't $3,000 anymore. But if Mr. Businessman invests this $1,920 and gets a 10% return, the money earns $192 each year. Well, not exactly $192. That interest is income, and it's taxable, too, by 36%. So it shrinks to $122.88. But if Mr. Businessman is prudent, if he reinvests all of his earnings, well, then at this rate, if Mr. Businessman never loses one penny of principal, if he never misses a day of interest, then 30 years later, at the age of 65, his yearly investment program has netted a total of $173,344. Not bad, huh? But who's interested in not bad when it could be better, much better? The law allows him and you the same tax advantages it allows the largest of corporations. It allows him and you the opportunity to invest profit dollars in a plan that will benefit him, his employees, and his company. It's not just one plan. The Internal Revenue Service lists allow many plans, each with countless variations, and each provides shelter from federal tax. In fact, they're called tax-sheltered plans. Now let's take the same man, but this time we'll put him in a tax-sheltered plan. The same investment of $3,000 and the same 10% annual return, with one big difference. There are no taxes on the $3,000 because we put him in a tax-sheltered plan. The whole $3,000 is all his. No maybes. The whole amount goes into the investment. At the same 10% return, the yearly earnings are $300. Now, there's where I blew it.
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 3, Take 1.
In fact, they're called tax-sheltered plans. Let's take the same man. But this time, we'll put him in a tax-sheltered plan. The same investment of $3,000 and the same 10% annual return, with one big difference. There are no taxes on the $3,000 because we put him in a tax-sheltered plan. The whole $3,000 is all his. No maybes. The whole amount goes into the investment at the same 10% return. The yearly earnings are $300. No taxes on this $300 either. He can prudently invest the whole amount. And then 30 years later, through the benefit of a tax-sheltered plan, Mr. Businessman's yearly investment program has grossed a grand total of $542,830. Now, at this point, according to law, if the money is withdrawn from the program, taxes are finally levied. Now, under the tax laws, which you can and should substantiate with your attorneys and CPAs, Mr. Businessman's nest egg after taxes should average a whopping $352,800. No plan, $173,344. With plan, $352,840. Interesting, isn't it? Why haven't more businessmen, all businessmen, invested in tax-sheltered plans? Well, maybe some. Maybe you haven't been advised that they exist. The tax avoidance is not tax evasion. You may put dollars aside in an employee retirement program to keep the good people you need to operate a successful business, to retire older people, to compete with others, for young people with new ideas that will enable you to grow and profit and expand. Now, the law understands it. The law understands the validity of a profit-sharing plan that gives your good and dependable employees a chance to participate in the future growth of a company they have helped to build. It's an incentive, and the law understands it. Perhaps you understand, and you've been advised to look into a tax-sheltered plan. But there are so many kinds, and there are literally hundreds of variations of each. Which one is for you? EBC, Employee Benefit Consultants, can help you make the right decision. We've programmed the computer.
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 4, Take 1.
Maybe some, maybe you, haven't been advised that they exist. The tax avoidance is not tax evasion. You may put dollars aside in an employee retirement program to keep the good people you need to operate a successful business, to retire older people, to compete with others for young people with new ideas that will enable you to grow and profit and expand. The law understands it. The law understands the validity of a profit-sharing plan that gives your good and dependable employees a chance to participate in the future growth of a company they have helped to build. It's an incentive. And the law understands it. Perhaps you understand, and you've been advised to look into a tax-sheltered plan. But there are so many kinds, and there are literally hundreds of variations of each. Which one is for you? EBC, Employee Benefit Consultants, can help you make the right decision.
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 5, Take 1.
EBC, Employee Benefit Consultants, can help you make the right decision. We program the computer with the most sophisticated of programs to provide you with the information that will help you make the right decision. With the profile of your company as one input, with your objectives as to whom you would like to reward for their loyalty as another input, and the law as a third input, we can provide a study of the alternatives for your decision. An array of alternatives and projected dollar results. Now, what kind of results will you be deciding upon? Look at some of the tax-sheltered plans that our computer uncovered for another business. Now remember, these are not necessarily for your business because every company is different. Its management objectives are different, just as its employees and products are different. The first one we'll look at is called a profit-sharing plan. It's probably the most popular type today. Let's assume that the company invests 15% of the payroll, the maximum allowable amount, in a profit-sharing plan. Let's estimate a 10% gain. Now, that's from earnings, appreciation, and forfeitures. Forfeitures occur when an employee leaves the job before developing a fully vested share. There are 14 employees. Among them, I am boss here, who's 61. Keyman, the boss's son, 33. Alice Nice, secretary. An old-timer and a delivery boy. 15% of the company's payroll consists of $20,549 a year. Let's simplify this printout study and see how the money is allocated according to ratio.
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 6, Take 1.
Let's assume that the company invests 15% of the payroll, the maximum allowable amount, in a profit-sharing plan. Let's estimate a 10% gain. Now, that's from earnings, appreciation, and forfeitures. Forfeitures occur when an employee leaves the job before developing a fully vested share. Now, there are 14 employees. Among them, I am boss, who's 61, Keyman, the boss's son, who's 33, Alice Nice, secretary, an old-timer, and a delivery boy. 15% of the company's payroll consists of $20,549 a year. Let's simplify this printout study and see how the money is allocated according to ratios established by their monthly incomes. Now here, this is how many dollars each employee would get from the account. And this is the percentage each employee would get also. Now, pay strict attention to these facts because they're important to you. Who gets the dollars and the percentage? The only stockholders in the company are the father and the son. They own all the stock. Now, you notice that 52% of every dollar goes to them in the beginning. $7,200 a year to I Am Boss, $3,600 to Keyman, his son. Let's take these dollars and accumulate them at 10%. What is the cash return? Based on a retirement age of 65 or 10 years, whichever comes later, these are the dollars. I am boss, 10 years, $114,749. Keyman, son, retirement at 65, $724,095. Now, if the money is a monthly income projection annuity using conservative annuity rates and adding Social Security to it, you get these figures right here. First of all, I Am Boss would get $916 a month. Keyman would receive $4,889 a month. Alice Nice, who's no kid, $983 a month. And the delivery boy, if he never got a raise, never got a promotion, would have $427,569 at the time of his retirement, or $2,888 a month in retirement income. Okay, it's easy to see that the benefits are outstanding. The plan takes pretty good care of almost everybody, and it certainly provides the company with a package of breathtaking incentives to attract and keep good employees and keep them happy. But does this plan make good business sense? Is it economically sound? In hard dollars and cents, what does it cost the company? To discover this, we have to take a look at what the company looked like before the plan. Let's assume this company had a $100,000 pre-tax income. To keep it simple, let's use a 50% tax bracket.
5. There's no tuning.
Employee benefit consultants. Segment 7, take 1.
To discover this, we have to take a look at what the company looked like before the plan. Now, let's assume the company had a $100,000 pre-tax income. To keep it simple, let's use a 50% tax bracket. The company paid $50,000 in taxes, and $50,000 went to the stockholders. Now, let's put in the plan and see what happens. $20,549 goes into the plan. Let's just simplify it and call it $20,000, leaving a taxable income of about $80,000. Of the $80,000, $40,000 goes for taxes. $40,000 goes to the stockholders. Now, without the plan, the profits were $50,000. With the plan, the profits were $40,000. What did the $20,000 per year profit-sharing plan cost the stockholders? Only $10,000, or so it seems on the surface. They put $20,000 in the plan, but $10,000 of that amount was formerly tax dollars. Well, how about the other $10,000? The difference in company profit, $40,000 versus $50,000. Forget it. Those $10,000 immediately went back to the stockholders in the form of direct benefits. More than $10,000 is invested in the stockholders' accounts. $10,800, to be exact. You can see right here. Now, what did the plan cost the stockholders? Nothing. In fact, they made money by having their dollars in the tax shelter. Now, is this the best plan for this company? It certainly was sound. It certainly made sense. It didn't cost them anything. Is this the best plan for this company? It might have been. Let's take a look at another plan that an EBC study projected, just one of the many possible plans.
Employee benefit consultants, segment 8, take 1.
Let's take a look at another plan that an EBC study projected. Just one of the many possible plans we submitted and might have recommended to this company. We call this an integrated pension plan, integrating the Social Security individually for each person. Since all employees are treated equally by Social Security on a fixed base, the government permits a private pension plan to exclude that base in setting up benefits on a total retirement program. In this plan, no contribution is made on those dollars for which we are making Social Security contributions. Those dollars are excluded. Also excluded are those employees who do not have 2 years of service at the time the plan goes into effect. This cuts out 7 employees, which leaves us now with 7 qualified employees rather than 14. Let's break out these 7 and see how I Am Boss and Key Man fare. Now, this plan, as you see here, requires little more than $11,299 per year in contributions, with $9,344 of that amount going to I Am Boss's pension plan. Total cash at retirement, $146,313. $1,264 monthly income, including Social Security. Now, which was the best plan for I Am Boss? Remember that he got out of the old plan? He got $114,700 and only 35% of the money. Now, here, he's getting over 82% of the money. Now, which is the best plan? Well, it all depends on whom you're interested in. If the principal of the concern is your principal concern, it's undoubtedly this one. Any drawbacks? Certainly. It didn't do much for Key Man's son, did it? Maybe it's possible to work out a compromise, a plan that will...
Employee benefit consultants, segment 9, take 1.
Any drawbacks? Certainly. It didn't do much for Key Man's son, did it? Maybe it's possible to work out...
Stand by. We're set. Stand by.
Any drawbacks? Certainly. It didn't do much for Key Man's son, did it? Maybe it's possible to work out a compromise, a plan that will serve your intended purposes better. Let's look at a combined plan projected by the EBC study, one that combines the features of both the pension plan and the profit-sharing plan. Let's take a look at what happens here. Let's take a look at the study's arithmetic. The participating payroll is $113,088. Remember, in a profit-sharing plan, up to 15% of the payroll can be placed in the plan. In a combination profit-sharing and pension plan for the same company, as much as 25% of the participating payroll can be contributed to the plan. 25% of $113,088 permits a maximum allowable contribution of $28,272 a year. Let's say the company, for economic reasons, decides it wants to contribute approximately $17,000, or $16,953 to be exact. That means the company has a carryover every year of $11,319, a carryover it could contribute in future years if it decided to do so. Okay, from this $16,953, what are the benefits? What does it buy? Well, number one is I Am Boss. He gets $11,744, or 69.3%, a 10-year total of $184,562. Now, that's certainly better than $114,749, and at less cost than the first plan. Our key man, the son, gets a yearly contribution of $2,532 a year, a total cash accumulation of $391,718. He's still not as well off as he was under the first plan. Or is he? Let's take a more sophisticated look. Remember, I Am Boss is 61. 10 years from now, he'll be out of the place. And remember, we have a carryover of some $11,000 each year we can contribute if we choose. Now, if the company can afford it, and it most likely can with I Am Boss off the payroll, another $16,319 a year can be contributed to the fund. And guess who gets the lion's share? Key Man's son. Now I Am Boss Jr.
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 10, Take 1.
Or is he? Let's take a more sophisticated look. Or is he? Let's take a more sophisticated look. Remember, I Am Boss is 61. 10 years from now, he'll be out of the place. And remember, we have a carryover of some $11,000 each year we can contribute if we choose. If the company can afford it, and it most likely can with I Am Boss off the payroll, another $11,319 a year can be contributed to the fund. And guess who gets the lion's share? Key Man's son. Now I Am Boss Jr. as president. With more personal income and the credit carryover, he isn't going to have much trouble running his $391,718 in this plan up to the approximate $700,000 figure the first plan offered, is he? Do you like this plan better than the other two? Is it feasible? Can the company afford it? Let's look. We start out with the same $100,000 pre-tax income, $50,000 for taxes, $50,000 for profit. With the plan $100,000 income, with approximately $17,000 contributed to the plan, reducing the taxable income to $83,000. $41,500 taxes,
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 11, Take 1.
Can the company afford it? Let's look. Let's start out with the same $100,000 pre-tax income. $50,000 for taxes, $50,000 profit. With a plan, $100,000 income, with approximately $17,000 contributed to the plan, reducing the taxable income to $83,000. $41,500 taxes, $41,500 profit. $8,500 less than the original $50,000 profit. So the $17,000 plan cost the company $8,500. But did it? Look here. About $14,276 went directly to the plan or the stockholders. They made over $5,000. Now, these are just some examples, a few for instances, but they illustrate what a tax-sheltered plan can do for you and what it can do for your employees and your company. Taking everything into consideration, what's the best plan for you? To make the right decision, you must get all the facts first. And this is where EBC comes in. We'll make a complete analysis of your business situation, whether a company with 10,000 employees or just one, whether you now have a plan or not, and the facts will be presented to our computer for examination and analysis. Your goals will be compared with the tax-sheltered plans permissible under law, and the computer prints out not a plan, but a full study showing many possible profitable plans. You scrutinize the benefits, weigh the benefits against the economics, the cost to you. Only then can you make an intelligent decision that a tax-sheltered retirement plan makes good business sense for you. It starts with the study. You see, I...
Employee Benefit Consultants, Segment 12, Take 1.
It starts with the study.